dinosaur. I sound like a dinosaur from Dinosaur Office. No, I lost my extended slash. It was just a user error. Voice of those guys. I don't, I'm not as good as Beardrow to know who voices what. Not, I don't have that couch commentary knowledge. Nor do I have a perma co-host. Now, it's only up here. Slash. Ow. That was busted. Oh, I forgot about you. Oh man. I almost ran headfirst into that sweet poison. Sword extender. Darn it, if only, only his projectiles were destructible. Darn it. My one weakness. A weakness. Yeah, I'm just gonna let you walk all the way over here again. Because I don't want to have to deal with your shenanigans. More than one hit. Out of SP again, huh? No longer out of SP. Gotta be mitigated though. Can't get please. But I got more health. Ow. Ow! That still does damage. That's insane. And annoying. That's more like it. There we go. Moved on. Area conquered. Ah, that's a farm. Scrambler. Whoa, geez. Ah, geez, Scrambler. Whoa. Ah, geez, Scrambler. What a... Lag. Not holding back for nothing, huh? Alright, see you later. Alright, see you later, man. Ow. 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 Better at this. Sparkler. Ow. 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 Jerk. Gotcha. Oh, jeez. Another form. Should have. Jaylico. Holy cow. Oh, of course. What the? Reactor explosion killed most of our clan and the rest were captured by synthetics. They drained me of my power to enhance their own. Our master must be freed before all is lost. Rise to the challenge. Rising fire, attack on the ground. Wow. Alright. I feel like we're gonna fight Legion by the end of this. Finally, a moment to breathe. Alright, it's time to fill you in on everything. When you get to Mecha City, you'll notice things have changed, and not for the better. Let me bring you up to speed. You knew Dr. Progen as the greatest mind in Mecha City. He built a machine capable of self-sustained autonomous function. A synthetic humanoid. They served as laborers, police, domestic servants, you name it! Mecha City was safe and prosperous, and our clan found new purpose in upholding its peace. Our commitment was total. Missions to dispose of malfunctioning synthetics were conducted in secret. One day, our master got injured in a freak accident. She was left clinging to life. Dr. Progen grew increasingly desperate to save our master. There were all kinds of rumors, strange experiments, disappearances. Without her, our clan began to drift apart. And then the explosion, it leveled the whole city. In the wake of destruction, all of the machines went berserk. As for Dr. Progen, driven mad with desperation, he became something else entirely. He's been tearing through Mecha City, hunting down survivors with the synthetic army. The situation is grave. We were barely able to find and save you in time. But all that matters now is finding and releasing our master. If you fail, Mecha City will only be the beginning. The destruction will keep spreading. Dang, he is definitely colored and basically Metal Gear Mark II from Snatcher. He's basically that character. And Turing from Read Only Memories 2064. This game's got a lot going for it. You can do it, Shadow. I know you can. Aw. It's gonna suck when you betray me. Mecha City Ruins. Well, that doesn't open those. I guess I should keep pressing on, as opposed to showing people, like, the secrets and stuff. I guess since this is, like, the game's fresh, just take it as, like, a play beneficiary thing of, like, play your own adventure. If you see me miss something, or want me to go back, you know, just tell me in the comment section. Going forward, like, playing games like The Messenger, which we haven't played yet, but definitely will. I just really, this game was basically like Katana Zero, like a game I really just wanted to, like, get my hands on. Nope. Song's a jam. The song's like, you now know exactly what happened. Swang Blade? Swang Blade. Okay, go ahead and be the best weapon in the game. It's fine by me. No skin off my back, really. Aw, oh, no, I took any damage. God, no, don't lose the Swang Blade. And I even like the name of it, Swang Blade. Thank you, Swang Blade. Thank you, Swang Blade. Man, Swang Blade, you're so good. Swag Blade. It's actually Swag Blade. I now have all the confidence of a black teenager of swagger. Finally. Wow, so this is a train car of some sort. Swang Blade! Dang. Dang, Swang Blade. You're so good, Swang Blade. Swag Blade. Swag. That definitely... Oh, Switch. Now it's going to get interesting. I mean, of course there was always different kinds of, like, weapons, but it's like, now you can find different weapons en route to objectives. Good. No. Trying to be careful. Not talking because they don't want to talk to you guys. I'm not talking because I'm trying to be careful. Being careful is not working out. It's not happening. It didn't happen, guys. I'm sorry. Man, this game's got so much depth. So cool. Going to have to take a lot of cues in this game. Going forward, Jumeca. Oh yeah, I should be talking more about Jumeca, no? Cyberpunk. Well, I really like RPGs. I really like the cyberpunk genre. I really like the idea of black people having more positive messages about their history and ancestry. And I like the idea of negative legends where you're basically recounting lost legacy and treasures for the modern era, people who are still alive, because that era is no longer relevant, because it's no longer existing, right? Civilization doesn't exist in the sense of like what existing means. So what I wanted to do with Jumeca, I wanted to create a world where the cyberpunk grittiness of this kind of idea was on the backdrop of very tropical places. I wanted to set it in the Caribbean, and it is, but I have written up about what I want to do, but I still need time for refinement. There's still plenty of time to like consider other ideas. Wow, this game is amazing. Like, so good! Yo, don't even try and play me. Oh, it's like, that looked like a secret. Their leader controls a weapon high in the clouds? Is that the master? Anyway, under the open, the sky is unsafe. I must stay hidden indoors. Oh, someone's... That's a corpse, no? Hardware, whatever. Ow. Well, guess the swag blade is not best. Oh no! Game's cryptic enough to give us those things like their leader controls weapon high in the clouds. Anywhere under the open sky is insane. Unless they hit the doors. Who are you? Oh, if I hit it. Oh. That's so cool. I wasn't even realizing that I was hitting the blade. That makes it much more effective. When you know what your weapon does, it makes you up that much more effective of a ninja. Ah, jeez. Oh, okay. Doesn't take much hits. Exploding projectiles and, low health bars. But my health bar isn't even low, like... Oh! Wow, that sucks. Not only does taking damage hurt more in terms of my pride now, but I realize, like, how important it is not to get hit. Wow. This weapon is incredible. Understand how to use it. Right? Like, it's like a yo-yo. Oh, man. Like, this is a very ingenious, like... The fact that it reacts to you hitting it makes it all the cooler. Civilians, this is an automated transmission. The city and surrounding islands have been secured with a safety perimeter. Please evacuate via train transit. So they sent them all underground. Not the best solution. Seems like there was a lot of casualties. Burn up. Why are you standing right there? Like, why don't you have the swag blade? It's like, right. Why don't I have the swag blade? Because you're garbage. That's why you don't have the swag blade. Right. I can't pretend like that's not what's happening. I don't have it, right? Oh, welcome everybody. Welcome back to Retrograde Where Plays Cyber Shadow. Cyberpunk retro-styled homage to the NES era games made by published by Yacht Club Games, made by it might be Metal Mind. I'm so sorry. It's been a few episodes now. This will be about we finished, I guess technically 4 episodes. This is episode 5. Might be the last episode for this series for today, but I really wanted to, like, not only get a head start on playing this game, talking a little bit more about my own series, Jameka, because this game is superb, and this has the cyberpunk motif down to a T, but I'm trying to chase the afropunk motif. I want to create nature and nurture, and the cohesion of technology and spirituality and humanity and community. That's what I'm trying to do in China. Also trying to make superheroes that black men can feel comfortable and happy about, knowing like there's more to them in terms of media than what is presented in a lot of media. Over here? Okay. I kinda had like see like now that I have swag blade like down here like I was doing better when I was talking, not focusing on the game itself. Because now I've gotten into a we've gotten we're 4 episodes in I've gotten into, basically, I learned how to use the swag blade. It's not, what was I calling it? Dang. Now I'm gonna have to, like, listen to the episode to, like, know what I was calling this weapon a second ago. And now I'm calling it its correct name. Its correct name is funnier than I think what I had. But I think what I had was still kinda funny? Who knows? I'm your host, RetrogradeWare's Curator. What's retrograde wear? You're wondering. It's like, well, it was a fun idea for me as a multimedia designer to design my own. What would I do if I had my own t-shirt company? And like, what kind of things would I want to see made or like put on clothing and whatnot? And now that I'm doing that, a lot of people, it's merch basically. Merch. Nerd merch. Pop culture merch. Very well could be Cyber Shadow merch in my brain right now, but I'm not trying to make a buck on somebody else's idea, but I would like to make something that says, I love Cyber Shadow, and if you watch this Let's Play of me playing it, thank you. Go buy this game. Shock explosions. What happened to the Sea of Flames? pesky, so I wanted to get rid of it. Dang it! Ugh. This game is heck of fun. It's gonna be hard to want to play it now. It's gonna be hard to want to play other things. It's like, I wanna like progress this. I'm gonna have to start a separate file. Why did you do that before? It's like, hey man, I didn't even know this game was coming out. This is a very impromptu let's play, to be honest with you. I didn't plan this at all. It's like, oh, it's out? Okay, alright. I mean, like, there's no time like the present. Oh, my gosh. So much.